thanks for staying with us right here on Sunrise as we continue this Hope Day Wednesday. Now, this week serves to highlight the importance of reducing salt intake in all populations throughout the world. Now, many of us know that eating too much salt is bad for our health and are actively looking to reduce the amount we eat. This is in comparison to a few years ago when the dangers of salt on health were widely unknown to the general public. But a study shows that it's still difficult for South Africans to shake the salt habit. So if you are among the many South Africans that find themselves reaching for the salt shaker at every mealtime, you may very well be a super taster, someone who has a heightened sense of taste. To try and find out how can you get rid of this habit, we have invited Dr. Marlin McKay. And you at home can be part of our conversation by giving us a call, of course, on 011-447-1742 or 1620. Your comments are also welcome on our Facebook and Twitter pages. Doctor, good morning. How are you this morning?
Good morning, I'm
very
well, thank you.
Me, salt, sugar, not moved. I can live without those. But I know that people struggle with that. Before they even taste, they're already adding.
Reaching for the shake.
So what actually triggers people to do that?
Yeah, so this is what this is all about. There seems to be some sort of a genetic predisposition. But it's just a bad habit, this automatic thing. Mm. And we tend to forget. Let me just say first, salt is not the issue. It's too much salt. It's extra salt. Mm. It's added salt. Mm. That's the problem. And salt is associated with greater risk of hypertension, high blood pressure, which is in turn associated with heart attacks and strokes. And you're seeing how many people, hundreds of people dying a day from
that. We've seen the rise of that happening, you know, in our country in the recent years. Things have just sort of like changed in the past 10 years. What would you say has influenced that?
So one of them would definitely be salt. The other one is obesity, increased carbohydrate, sugar intake, which leads to obesity. Mm. And the fact that we're not moving as much as we used to. Or as we should. Mm. And so those contributing factors with heightened cholesterol levels, diabetes levels, have all increased the risk of dying from heart attacks and strokes. And we're seeing an epidemic of heart attacks and strokes. Mm. And so coming back to the issue of salt, it's exactly what you're saying. We're just reaching. It's a bad habit. But it's not so much the added salt, the salt that we are adding. Mm. It's eating salt that is already in food.
So can we talk about that? Because, you know, some would argue is that we don't even know how to read the labeling. So we don't know what contains salt and what doesn't. So when we get the food, it's already got salt in it and then we add on top. So how can we remedy that?
Okay, so the first thing we need to know that anything that's not fresh, anything that is processed, coming back to anything that's in a box, turned packet, usually has salt added. So our breads, our cereals, our canned foods, right, all have salt, added salt. Mm. And so when we buy something off the shelf, we need to look at the food label. Mm. If that label, so our daily, total daily requirement of salt should not be more than 5 grams. Per day. We are probably eating 2 to 3 times as much. Mm. So that's about 1 teaspoon of salt per day that we should be eating. Now, if you look at the food label, it should not have more than 1.5 grams per 100 grams. Mm-hmm. Just remember that number. 1.5 is already too much. Should be below that. Mm. Okay? And then, so the idea is for us not to add salt, to keep things as fresh as possible, more fruit, more vegetables, less processed
food. Eat things from trees, not...
There we go again, right back to square one.
Yes. Okay, we're also taking your calls this morning. You can ask the doctor, of course, on 011-447-1742 or 1620. All right, doc, then there's a group of people, you know, who are like, oh, no, you know, I don't do, you know, normal table salts. You know, there's kosher salt, there's sea salt. Are those things?
Yeah, so if you're really going to get technical, sometimes we say, you know, the Himalaya, the rock salt is a bit better, the pink salt
is a little better. Yeah.
But we are now talking about the quantity. Mm. So what it comes down to. So if you're going to choose a healthy alternative, still be careful of that extra salt. If it amounts to more than 5 grams per day, it's going to be dangerous. Mm. It's going to result in elevated blood pressure. And I think an important thing comes through is, especially with Salt Awareness Week for 2018, is watching the salt that our kids take in, because this is where the habit starts.
Okay, so how do we watch for that? What are the things that we should be looking out for, especially when it comes to our kids?
Okay, so number one, remove the salt shaker from the table.
From the table, okay.
So it's a taste that gets developed.
Yes.
And so we feed on that.
So I was gonna say, can you train the taste buds not to?
Just like we can do with sugar, you can. Okay. So you cut down gradually. Don't do it overnight.
Okay.
Remove it from the table. Okay. Keep things as fresh as possible. Eat more fruit and vegetables. Let's use flavor instead of salt. So use herbs and chilies and sage and thyme and garlic. Add those things instead of adding salt.
Mm.
Get the food tastier rather than saltier.
Okay.
You see? And then reading the labels.
Yes. All right?
And as I said, the breads and the cereals are probably our biggest culprit.
Mm.
So if we start training our kids, not just watching what we eat, watching what our kids eat, and removing the salt from the table and removing the already inherent salt from the food that we are buying, we're already starting to win that battle.
All right, let's take Rejoice on the line. Rejoice, thanks for holding your comment or question this morning.
Yes, good morning.
Yes, go ahead.
Okay, sisi, ngithi mina ngicela ukubuza udokotela lapho ukuthi eningi nenkinga la uyazi umkhwenyana wami ngifike ngipheke ukudla ngibuza ukuthi ku taste kodwa yena aphinda ede another taste.
Yeah, that was going to be my next question, where Rejoice, I was going to ask you, okay, I know there's different amounts, guidelines for men versus women, but I've just seen with like my brothers, my male friends, before they even taste the food, they're the good shakers.
Yeah. So we don't make a big boo-ha about guidelines for men versus women.
Mm.
It's a general guideline that we say.
Okay.
No added salt. We have to get out of that habit. And this is why I say, remove the salt shaker from the table. Start working on cutting down your salt intake.
Mm.
Work on foods that already have natural sodium in your fruit and your vegetables and your things. And if you're adding that flavor, and if you know the food labels, you have to start cutting down. You think of everything that you eat from morning till evening.
Mm.
Should not be more than a teaspoon. And I bet you if you do it today in terms of what we are already eating, probably 2 to 3 times more. We're having 2 or 3 teaspoons of salt per day compared to 1 teaspoon.
Okay, so what must Joyce do for her husband? She says her husband, even though she knows that her food is tasty, he's already adding.
So allow him to cut down gradually. Don't remove it immediately.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? Number two, start reading the food labels and show him the food label. When you buy something, take the groceries out of the cupboard and start getting into habit. Show him how much salt he's actually using, how much salt is already in there and that he's already adding. And then, after a couple of weeks, remove the salt shaker. Concentrate on
just
flavor.
Just don't buy that salt thing and put it on the table.
And then flavor.
Add flavor to the food.
And more fruit and veg.
All right, let's take another caller. We've got Kenny from Cape Town. Hi, Kenny.
Good morning.
Good morning. How are you?
I'm fine, thank you.
Yes.
Could you please ask the doctor, salt is sodium chloride, if I'm correct, and it's bad for everybody. I mean, it's especially for diabetics. There's a product on the market called No Salt, which is actually just plain potassium chloride. Is that good or is it bad?
Okay, so again, salt, as it correctly says, it's a 40% sodium and 60% chloride.
Mm.
Remember, salt is an essential nutrient, essential mineral in our bodies.
Mm.
It's the added salt that's the problem.
Mm.
And this is the whole point that we're making.
Mm.
If you're getting your salt from natural products, it's fine.
Mm.
Potassium salt, be careful, because then you may increase your potassium, which can affect the heart.
Yeah. Okay.
So one has to be very, very careful. And what we are really saying is, don't look for replacement. If you are going to replace it with flavor, the spices that I mentioned.
Okay.
But not be careful of using other types of salt. Just cut down on the quantity of salt that we are using.
Mm. Yeah, and I know, I mean, for a lot of people who like, when you say spices, we mean natural herbs are probably the best, because a lot of people pick up a lot of spices that are out in the market, you know, don't read the labels of that, and some of them are actually just filled with a lot of salt.
Absolutely, absolutely. Keep it as natural as possible. Keep it as close to a plant as possible.
Close to a plant, back to
and
the plant.
In a plant.
Eat plants, not things from plants. Okay. Well, Doc, thanks very much for chatting to us. Obviously, we're trying to take action against salt control in the country, salt intake in the country. And we hope that we win that battle, because it is contributing to some of the challenges that we face when it comes to our health. That was Dr. Marlin McKay talking to us about the importance of reducing.